What's up, guys? Welcome back to the Mastery Podcast. Now, for those of you who are listening to this episode, you won't really see how different things are today, because I have decided to record today's episode, the solo round, for the first time, so that those of you who are on YouTube are able to watch this. And then this will, you know, as normal, be going out on the audio version on the main podcast. So in today's episode, I want to talk to you about online coaching, but I want to talk to you about the difference between starting an online coaching business and growing an online coaching business. You see, I see so many of you, of fitness professionals, getting very, very confused with the terminology that you're using and the frustration that it can bring. Now, let's look at starting an online coaching business. Let's get you to appreciate and understand the difference between the two. Now, I'm going to be absolutely honest with you. Starting an online coaching business from scratch is not an easy thing to do. Starting a personal training business from scratch is not an easy thing to do. There are many skills and qualities that you need, and I'm going to delve into what they are so you can kind of work out, am I starting an online coaching business? Am I speaking to somebody about growing it? I'll always look at around about 10 clients. If you have less than 10, zero, you're starting an online coaching business. If you have zero completely, you're obviously starting an online coaching business. If you have over 10, there are some characteristics that you will already have and some things that you're doing which clearly are positioning yourself able to acquire clients. Now, let me look at someone who's starting an online coaching business. Now, very often, you won't have an avatar. You won't know who it is that you're talking to. In fact, I'll go on your social media page and I'll have a look, and it'll be very, very clear to me that you don't know who you're talking to. That's the first thing. The second thing is there's very little engagement. There's no one leaving comments. You're not asking for any engagement. So you're not really clear on the fundamental rules of engagement with social media and platforms. The third thing is going to be about your confidence. And I can see this in writing, and you'll know within yourself. Are you a coach or a person that's confident? If you're somebody that hides behind photos all the time and never puts pictures of yourself, if you're somebody that never puts videos out of yourself, I would naturally say that you struggle with confidence. And as a result, when I look at a coach that's picking up clients, signing up clients, I'll see more confidence. And the evidence of confidence is going to be able to write about what it is that you do. I mean, we're not even going to get to results yet. You know, when you write a post, are you somebody who does one or two lines of post, of content, or are you somebody that actually is pretty fluid in the way that you write? You kind of would have looked a little bit into copywriting, or you're confident in your abilities, so you're sharing a lot about your journey, your stories, you understand what journey you've been on. And in all fairness, somebody who's looking to grow their online coaching business, I would always say that they've got a degree of journey that is evident. Because let's be honest, for somebody to hire you as a coach, they really need to be able to see that you can do the thing that you say you do. So many people will say to me, you know, I'm struggling to get clients. And it's like, well, what do you have that somebody would want? Well, I share a lot of information. So does everybody else. What is it about you? What is it about your service? Is there evidence that there is a service? Is there evidence of a result? Is there evidence of you working with clients? Is there evidence of your own journey? Maybe not. I'm not really on my own journey at the moment. I'm just, you know, at the fundamental foundations of the fitness industry. And therefore, I would say, well, lower your expectations. You know, as a personal trainer going into the gym, you've just qualified. And you say to yourself, I don't really know much about fitness industry. I haven't really got a lot of confidence in what I do. So I will always say to somebody, manage your expectations. Manage your expectations to the point where it is going to take you a little bit of time to find your feet. It is going to take a little bit of time to learn how to talk to people on the gym floor. It is going to take you time to know how to, you know, just approach people, even putting programs together for people for free sessions, or, you know, learning how to deliver something for free and how to have conversations and getting it right and getting it wrong. I always find this such an enjoyable part of working with any fitness professional. And I say to so many coaches that hire me to help them start an online coaching business, let's get things, some things straight. From this list, your, do you have a brand? Do you have colors? Do we know your brand colors? Do we know your brand values? We know your brand standards. And values and standards is all about what you stand for, what reputation you want to have. Do you know the type of clients you like to work with online? Are you fully confident with what you know? Are you able to write clearly and articulate? Do you have nice photos of you? Do you have nice videos of you? Do you produce any results? And if somebody goes down that list and they say, no. And I say, well, great, that's not a problem. But are we gonna agree that we're gonna take you on a journey to building all those things? Yeah, I'm looking forward to doing that. So would I be right in saying that straight away, if you don't have any of those things, is it right that you're gonna sign up a lot of clients? And the likelihood is no. But will you, just like a personal trainer starting in the gym, will you? Of course you will. Every single person that I work with signs up clients. But you end up with a lot of frustration because you don't have any, because you're not enjoying the process of getting there. So I want you to kind of understand, starting a personal training business, you know, no brand, no avatar, no engagement, very little self-confidence, really unable to write good posts and understand how to try and engage with people. You are starting your online coaching business. All right, there's some fundamentals there, confidence being one of them. You know, I'm talking to you now from, you know, and speaking to you on here with many, many years of experience, but I remember what it was like to be low in self-confidence. Gosh, I really remember what it was like to be low in self-confidence. Didn't know what to talk to people about, didn't feel like I knew enough in the fitness industry, and as a result, my expectations were managed. I knew that it was very unlikely that I was going to be getting great clients, or even, you know, just any clients. So I would just keep working and working. And I see so many of you who are starting online coaching businesses, spending 3 or 4 days between doing posts, maybe putting out the odd story every so often, certainly not DMing people and putting calls to action in your posts, and expecting one post that is coming from a low in self-confident, lacking results, lack of knowledge person, and you get very disappointed you don't have a client. And that really should be something that you should say, well, I'm learning, so I'm gonna manage my expectations. Now, on the flip side of this, we've got growing an online coaching business. So if we've got something that started to sprout, right, then we can start to nurture it and help it grow. Right? You got a baby, lower your expectations of what a baby can do, but then you can help a baby to grow. And you can start teaching it and giving it habits and learning different things. And this is what growing an online coaching business is all about. And if I have somebody coming to see me that says, I've got about 10 online clients, and I go, great. So would I say that you are quite clear with who it is you're speaking to? Yeah. Well, I go through a process and I say, are we certain? I'm gonna go through a bit of your content and say, I like what you write, but I think it's just lacking a bit of certainty. Because now we're getting from 10 to 20 to 30 online clients, and even way further beyond that, we need to be utter clarity with the avatar. Then we're gonna look at engagement. We're gonna look at making more income. So we're gonna look at engagement strategies. We're gonna look at, you're currently doing great engagement strategies, but how do we build on that? Can we develop some email marketing strategies? Can we collect some emails? Are we looking at your pricing and say, well, you've got 10 clients, we want to grow an online coaching business. Are you earning enough for those 10 clients relative to the level of service that you're delivering? No, I'm not. Am I doing really valuable lives? Am I putting very valuable content out in video format with the confidence that I already have? Am I looking at the conversations that I'm having with people and actually developing my sales skills to be able to help me sell my coaching at a price that I deserve? Have I looked at different ways of being able to convert clients and develop, as I said, email marketing strategies that help more people come onto your page and engage with you? Maybe we're starting to look at the point of, taking your social media to the point of some paid advertising when you're getting to 20, 30, 40 clients. You want to reach more people. You want to put more marketing strategies together. But these are all growth strategies. Some people are at the 60, 70 online client mark and they're ready for a team. And that's growing. Like that, this is growing. So if you're going to reach out to somebody and say, you know, I've got 10 to 15 online clients, I'm looking to grow that, I know that you've got some things in place already. If I've got no clients or I've got one or two, then the one or two might have come from friends and family. One or two might have come from, you know, somebody reaching out to speak to you and you ended up, you know, booking them in as a client. And that's kind of like a one-off and they might not be a perfect client. And you're able to say, right, I'm starting or I'm growing. And I want you to understand that, because in order for you to be able to manage your expectations in those situations, you know what work's necessary to be done. So starting an online coaching business, you've got to build the foundations. You've got to get clear on your audience. You've got to work on your own self-confidence. You've got to work on who it is that you're actually speaking to. You've then got to be consistent with your content and then show up and show confidence. You've got to learn how to write. You've got to learn how to create video. You've got to learn the fundamentals of graphic design. Like if you're putting graphics together, do they look cheap? Do they look good? You know, learn the fundamentals of those things. You know, learn the fundamentals of marketing. Learn the fundamentals of digital marketing. Because I enjoy this process. Now, I understand so many of you, I want to get clients. Well, there's so many strategies when you learn that you can learn how to have conversations and engage with people. So you can start conversations, develop a Facebook group, start bringing people into your world. You know, maybe you're running some low-level free programs or very low price programs to get multiple people in. So at least you can get people in at a lower price point to start being able to support these people on their journey, whether it's through a Facebook group, whether it's through a low level challenge. But please understand this. If you're starting out and you go, right, I'm going to do a challenge, I'm going to bring all these people in, and you don't get any takers, well, you're not getting any takers because the people don't really understand what it is that you do yet. However, somebody comes to see me and says, look, Mark, I've got 10 to 15 online clients I want to grow. All right. Now, do we want to grow just as an online coaching business with one-to-one clients, i.e. one-to-one online coaching? Or do we want to grow by introducing something such as a challenge, whether it's an 8-week challenge, a 6-week challenge? Do we want to go from the amount of clients that you've got now and bring a team on and actually start to move your team forward? And then we make that decision. But very often with people looking to grow their business, the business has established its reputation. So when people say, look, you know, I haven't really got a reputation online, I don't really know my avatar, I've not got a lot of confidence, but I'm going to drop a product in. The likelihood of people going to buy that product straight off the bat, like, I'm selling my online coaching, Mark, I'm selling my online coaching, it's not going to sell because no one really connects with what you do. So this is where I always explain to people starting an online coaching business. Use your personal training business. Use your personal training business to put results out, to show your journey, to show your story, and not be in the desperation to go online realizing that you've got low in self-confidence, no clarity with your audience, you're not able to write, you're not able to present results, and you sit there being very frustrated that online coaching is a very difficult world to grow in. And it is. Even if you have all the systems, you have to become very, very good at them. When it comes to scaling or growing your online coaching business, having more clients, then the likelihood of you having conversations and the DM strategies working with people, and even paid advertising strategies, you know, building funnels for lead magnets. You know, lead magnet is essentially a document that you give away to somebody for free in exchange for an email address. Well, let me explain something to you. If you're starting an online coaching business and people don't know what you do, you haven't really nurtured your audience online yet to really appreciate what it is that you do. And so when you put a lead magnet out, for example, how to lose a certain amount of weight in a period of time, if your audience don't really gel with what you're talking about yet, they're not going to want to download it. Yet if you're somebody that's been achieving body transformations and you put out, you know, a seven step blueprint video series to help people achieve their very own body transformation, somebody's going to be like, look, wow, he, she, fantastic at achieving body transformations. I'm in, I'm all in. I'm going to download that thing. And then you get 7 days worth of videos, and that's the point that people connect with you. So you can start building all these things when you're new from an online coaching perspective, but In terms of whether or not people will bite and whether or not people will take these products and services from you, whether it's free or paid, is very, very dependent on whether or not they've built a relationship and a connectivity with your brand. Your brand is you. You are a personal brand. And that's why for me, I separate the two. You know, I love working with both. When you're a personal trainer, you work with people who have never trained in a gym. And then you have people that have trained in a gym. They know what they're doing. You can step the pace up faster, right? Beginner in the gym, never trained. Never followed a diet before, heavily overweight. You have to work at basic habits such as like when they're getting up in the morning, how much water to drink, the cleanliness of their diet, and just slowly bring the weight down, increase their exercise activity. It's a little bit slower. But it's hugely rewarding because the person can see the end goal because they're working with you. Then there's somebody that comes in and says, hey, I'm all in. You know, I've been training pretty hard, but I want to get lean and I want to build some better shoulders. That's the person, it's go time, right? And I think what happens in the fitness industry is so many of you are saying that you want to grow an online coaching business. So your psychology is that I want to get to 20, 30 online clients. What you don't realize is that you've not said, I need to start first. And I want to enjoy the starting part. I remember when my reputation wasn't anything and no one really knew who I was. I loved having conversations with people. I loved putting my story out there, whether or not it was just talking to people, socializing in local magazines in the local area. But when I hit online, then I would just document my training. I would show the results I was achieving with people in the gym. And I knew I was, you know, now having, in hindsight, I look back at what I was doing. I was just connecting with people. I was building my reputation. I was getting my brand, building my self-confidence, talking to more people. And as I focused on that, so did the inquiries, so did the engagement, so did the people wanting to work with me. And I would just watch everything grow strategically, you know, very, very, very slowly, bit by bit. So as a coach, I saw the value in patience back then. I took my time developing my knowledge, my skill, my ability to engage, my rapport building, everything that you would have been taught as personal trainers throughout the years, but you suddenly move that into an online environment and you're like, no, I'm here to grow it. And I'm like, you're here to start it. It's very, very exciting. If you're listening to this episode right now and you are at the 10 to 15 mark, and you're already showing that you can get engagement and but it's not really moving at a pace, I guarantee there's 7, 8, 9, 10 things that you're not doing that will enable you to go from 20 to 30. And this is where there's a big difference in the online coaching world, is that you've nailed the fundamentals. And I guarantee, you know, if you're listening to this episode or watching this episode and you say to yourself, wow, I actually remember what Mark's talking about. I remember that phase where no one was biting online, no one was really paying attention to what I was doing. And then suddenly somebody just went, oh, I'm really interested in what you do. Or suddenly someone would leave a comment under your post and you go, there's the moment when my posts became engageable. People started to want to leave messages. You know, there's come a point in my career now with the book that I've written and the videos I do and the podcast I do and the YouTube that I give people so many opportunities to connect, but it's all about helping fitness professionals take their purpose and passion and build a business. So, well, it's a successful business. And this for me is, you know, that's taken me years to build. You know, I can't just go out and say, that's what I do without social proof. And so anybody that's building a business, their expectations at the beginning is that it's not going to be as lucrative. Now, here's the other thing. If you're starting out building an online coaching business, you're starting out, yet I'm going to give you a classic example. You're in shape, you're confident in your ability, you really know what you're on about. Maybe you're a PT, you've been doing it for quite a few years, and maybe you've competed, maybe you played sport, you're really confident. Confident to have your photo taken, confident to do an IG live, confident to do stories, you document your journey, you're a very fun person, you know, you talk about your nutrition, your training, you talk about the people you've worked with in the past, but you've never really done a lot online. And then you start to notice that people are engaging, people like you, you get plenty of follows. Then you will go very quickly from starting an online coaching business to picking up clients. And when you start to pick up clients, then it starts to build momentum pretty quickly. And that's somebody that says, look, I've been doing online coaching for 6 months and I've got like 15, 16, 20 clients, but I really want to go to the next level. And I say, look, you've got the attributes. You know, I talk about excellence attributes in Level Up. You've got the attributes of somebody that's perfect right now to develop your online coaching business. And I often don't take credit for a lot of that, because if someone's got the personality, the knowledge, the skill, but they don't necessarily have the ability with the digital marketing experience, and I jump in and layer that on, you know, they've done a lot of the hard work in developing themselves to get to where they are, and I'll just put the little connect the dots, and they'll go from 15, 20 online clients to 30, 40 online clients, you know, within 6 to 12 months, or even 6 months. And so if you're starting, it's managing your expectations. You know, no avatar, no engagement, you're low in self-confidence, you're not able to write, you're not happy with your self-image, you're not really, no one really notices you or knows that you're there. So you do every day, you focus on getting clear on that. Every day you focus on your avatar, every day you focus on building your physique, your training, your knowledge, your skill, your own training, you document that, and your confidence starts to build. You start to build a presence, you start to build something, you build into something that people want to follow and be a part of. And when we get to that point, that's when you'll start to be able to tell people, this is what I do. And then when you get to the point of saying, this is what I do, people are interested, and then you can start getting people on the call, you can start pushing people into a Facebook group. And then at that point, you might be in a position where you're able to run a low-level, cheaper challenge. It might be at that point where you can have conversations about working with people. But until then, understand the difference between starting an online coaching business and enjoy that process. For some of you, you'll connect the dots very, very quick and build your business very, very quick. And for some of you, you won't. But understanding those kind of measures that I've given you will enable you to say, am I growing my online coaching business? Am I actually just starting out? How to start your online coaching business. And that manages expectations. And you know what? Many of you quitting a job to be an online coach. And if you aren't confident, you don't have an avatar, you don't have an audience, you don't have a ability to write or create videos or anything like that, why would you actually stop your job to start something that you know is going to take time to build? So that is something that I always want to give people. If you can back yourself, and you know exactly what you've got to do, and you know that you're very disciplined to make it work, then good on you, but lower your expectations as to what you think is gonna happen in such a short space of time. As always, guys, if you found today helpful, make sure you drop me a message on Instagram. Say hi, or even, you know, this is on YouTube, leave a comment on the podcast, as you always do. Let me know on Instagram, and guys, I shall speak to you very soon.